protesting farmers of Punjab are threatening to reach the borders of Delhi again. There are already protests at the Shambhu border, on the Punjab-Haryana border, and the farmers are coming to Delhi with the main demand that there should be a guaranteed law on the minimum support price. The farmers are saying that every crop which is produced in India should be procured at MSP by the center. Now let's put these figures into the perspective, because there's a lot of talk going on, why is the government not agreeing to this? What is a guaranteed law on MSP? A guaranteed law on MSP on all crop produced in the country, I know, would mean a burden of almost rupees 40 lakh crore on the government exchequer. This is equivalent to almost the entire union budget, expenditure budget of the country, which stands at about 45 lakh crore in the present interim budget. So 45 lakh crore is the entire expenditure budget of the country. And if the demand of the farmers for an MSP for every produced crop in the country is agreed to, it would mean a fiscal burden of rupees 40 lakh crore. If we speak of only the MSP mandated crops so far, if all the MSP mandated crops in the country have to be procured by the government, as the farmers also demand, it would mean a burden of almost rupees 10 lakh crore on the government exchequer. This is almost equivalent to the entire capital expenditure budget of the government in the upcoming financial year, which stands about 11.11 lakh crore. So for to procure every crop in the country at MSP, the cost is 40 lakh crore, equivalent to our entire expenditure budget. If only the MSP mandated crops are to be procured from across the country, the cost is about 10 lakh crore, equivalent to almost the capex budget. So these figures actually put in perspective why the center is not in favor of a law on guaranteed MSP, because it will upset the entire fiscal balance of the country. If we look at the capex budget, you know, it is spent on roads, airports, highways, railways. If that entire equivalent of that entire budget is spent on MSP mandated crops, we can imagine how big an impact that will have on the exchequer. Also one thing to be clarified here, that the entire MSP produced in the country is presently not procured by the government. The entire MSP, total value of agricultural produce in the country is about 40 lakh crore. The total agricultural produce, the market value of the MSP mandated crops is about 10 lakh crore. The government in the last financial year procured MSP crops worth about rupees 2.5 lakh crore, which is about 25% of the total produce, because farmers also sell their produce in the open market. Everybody doesn't come and sell the MSP mandated crops to the government. So in a way, the farmers are demanding that nothing in the open market, everything will have to be procured by the government, and that is why the government feels that, you know, this could be a big fiscal burden on the government. That said, even last year when rupees 2.5 lakh crore has been spent on procuring MSP mandated crops, that is almost a 115% rise from 2014-15. In 2014-15, the Modi government had spent about rupees 1.06 lakh crore to procure MSP mandated crops. That has gone up to almost, the figure I have with me here is that has gone up to almost 2.28 lakh crore in the last financial year. So that's almost 115% rise. If we speak of the total quantum of the produce which has been procured by on MSP, that is also up. The figures I have is that MSP based procurement of food grains, you know, has increased from 761 lakh metric tons in 2014-15, up almost 38% to 1062 lakh metric tons in 2022-23. So even the money spent on MSP procurement is up 115% in 9 years. The quantum of food grains procured is also up 38% in the last 9 years. So obviously the government has all the intentions to procure as maximum as it can MSP mandated crops at the price fixed by the government. Not just that, the MSP price which is fixed for the crops is also steadily on an increase in the last many years. So if you look at just 2 years back, which is the major MSP crop, it's obviously paddy. The MSP for paddy in the financial year standard report at rupees 2183 per quintal. It is up by rupees 243 from 2 years back. The MSP for wheat, the figure I have presently, stands at 2275. It's up rupees 250 from 2 years ago. The MSP for jowar has risen by rupees 442 over the last 2 years, for ragi by 469. The rise in MSP in cotton is, in fact, has risen by rupees 894 in the last 2 years and stands at rupees 6620 for every quintal right now. So, you know, the government is very clear that, you know, if an MSP guarantee law is to be brought, the government is looking at an expenditure of at least 10 lakh crore just to procure every mandated MSP crop in the country. This is equivalent to almost the entire capex budget. to accede to the bigger demand of farmers to procure every crop would mean devoting almost the entire union budget to this exercise. This would really put India's target of becoming the third largest economy in the world, you know, into serious jeopardy. It could also maybe expose people like you and me and normal people, you know, middle class, to more taxation through direct and indirect taxes. That is also being hinted by some, because it's such a huge expenditure and MSP has to be incurred. The money has to come from somewhere, isn't it? To end it, you know, on this discussion, is there some politics behind it also? This is also in the BJP circle to talk, is that there is some politics behind it. Because, you know, if you see how the Aam Aadmi Party and the Congress both have lent support to the farmer agitation, the AAP has given virtually a free pass to the farmers in Punjab to come to the Shambhu border where we are seeing skirmishes, and to come to, through Haryana to the Delhi border. And, you know, the Congress have obviously said very clearly that it is backing the demands of the farmers. So is this also, this protest, is it political in nature before the 2024 Lok Sabha elections, is a question that, you know, is hovering now in political circles.